Let's look at another Final Cut Pro 10 tool in this video. In this one, I want to show you the position tool, which is this little icon under the tools menu. And your normal tool is the arrow tool or the select tool, which looks like that. But if you click and hold on the tools menu, you can go and select the position tool. The position tool is very helpful for, at least I find so, for people that are used to editing either with Avid or maybe Adobe Premiere, and they're not used to the magnetic timeline. That could be something that is a little annoying to get used to. And here's what I mean. When you are using the select tool, and let's say we select this second clip of everyone jumping around, I can click and drag this over here, and you'll notice the clips move around automatically because of the magnetic timeline, and it lets you really easily rearrange clips and position things. However, this is not a normal behavior if you're coming from another NLE like Adobe Premiere or Avid Media Composer, one of those. So I'm going to use Command Minus here to shrink down the timeline, kind of zoom out a little bit. I'm going to switch to my position tool, and let me show you what happens with the position tool. If I click and drag this clip, you'll notice we're not seeing any of the magnetic timeline behavior. If I drag it all the way over here and let go, what it's done is left a gap clip where the clip used to be and created another gap clip here to put this one over here. So when you're rearranging clips, if you want to just put them in a specific spot and you don't want all the other clips to move around, use the position tool and you can then leave gaps when you move a clip, say, above the timeline outside of the primary storyline. And that's what the position tool is really for. It's your way of being able to move things around and put it in exactly the right spot for where you want to put it, not where the magnetic timeline wants to put it. Now again, for me, this is something I rarely do because I usually like to trust the magnetic timeline and I understand how the magnetic timeline works. So I usually don't want all of these little gap clips all over the place. So again, usually I would recommend using the select tool, which again, you can use the shortcut A on the keyboard to get to it. That way, when you move things, like we can go in here and move things around to get rid of all of those gap clips. We could just move clips and we can see it's going exactly lined up next to the other clip. And I can just delete all these gap clips to get back to more of a standard project where all the clips are together. So if you do it this way, using the select tool, you're going to avoid a lot of those little one frame, maybe flash frame gap clips that you see. But there are definitely times where using that position tool is helpful so you can move clips around. And I've shown this with the other tools, but when you're switching between any of these tools, use the shortcuts on the right side, get used to them. If you use the position tool all the time, you should be using the letter P on the keyboard to switch to that tool. And what I mean by that is I've just pressed the letter P. I now have the position tool active. I can go move this clip. And then if I want to switch back to the other tool, I can press the A key on the keyboard. And now my select tool or arrow tool is now active. However, the position tool, you might stay active on that a while, but if you know you're just trying to move one clip and then you're going to be done, hold the P key down after you push on it, make your drag, and then let go of it. And you'll notice it automatically switches back to the previous tool you had selected. In this case, the arrow tool. So again, hold P, do your positioning, let go of P, and you'll switch back to the previous tool. So that's the position tool inside of Final Cut Pro 10. Did you find that helpful? If you did, give this video a thumbs up, like it. That always helps me know which videos you really like and what I should spend more focus on. Otherwise, if there's something I didn't cover that you want to see, leave a comment below, let me know. And then you can also always send me an email, finalcutprohelp@me.com. And that'll avoid any of the public comments if you don't want to see that. Or if you want to include a video or a screenshot, there's something that you see that you don't understand, a screenshot is always very helpful. You can send that over to me and I'll help explain it. Otherwise, have a wonderful rest of your day.